We're sitting in Danida Fellowship Center's garden with Nana Sars, who's a sector counselor in Myanmar. You're working with labor regulations and working environment in Myanmar. Can you tell us about how it is in Myanmar and what the Danish role in it is?
Since Myanmar opened in 2011, they have had a big reform process going on, aiming towards democratization and a market-based and socially equal, more equal society. In this development process, the labor market reforms are also very important, especially for the European and the Danish companies who are sourcing and investing in Myanmar. For them, it's important that Myanmar lives up to international standards and that they are sure that the products are produced where the workers have decent conditions.
You're also sending participants from your partners to Danida Fellowship Center's courses, one of them being occupational safety and another course about leadership. And I think so far you've sent 50 participants through the systems here. So can you say something about how they impact in your work in Myanmar?
There is only about 65 occupational safety and health inspectors in Myanmar. For the Danida Fellowship programs, it's very attractive for the participants from Myanmar to participate in these programs. And also for the Strategic Sector Cooperation program, it's a very good element in the program to be able to send the students to Denmark.
Unfortunately, since COVID-19 set in the beginning of the year, we have had to cancel some of our courses, but some of them have also been running online. Mm-hmm. And you have been sending participants to some of the courses there. Can you say something about the advantages and disadvantages?
It's important and it's of big value that we keep on having the Danida Fellowship courses, even though it has to be online for a while. So I hope that it's possible, and I'm sure that it is, to keep the courses going, even though it's on the other side of the world and it's behind the screen.